If we say that grace in the New Testament has abolished even the moral requirements of the law, we are going straight against the words of Jesus. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus says, I have not come to destroy the law, but I have come to fulfill it. And if you take, for example, Jesus' interpretation of the commandment against adultery, which was part of the Old Testament, the Ten Commandments, Jesus actually raises it further. He says, if a man looks at a woman to lust after her, he is guilty of adultery. And the commandment against murder, Jesus says, if I hate somebody, then I am guilty of murder. So it is wrong to say that the New Testament abolishes the moral dimensions of the Old Testament law. No, no, no. The moral dimensions of the Old Testament law are actually enhanced by Jesus Christ. But what is not required now by the law is the ceremonial, particularly the separatist statements of the law in the Old Testament. For example, a Jew should not eat with a non-Jew. Those are the things which Jesus has done away with. Paul again, in Galatians chapter 3, says the Old Testament was our schoolmaster to bring us to Christ. For example, when a child is growing up in a Christian home, we tell the child, you should do this, you should not do that. But eventually, we should lead that child to faith in Christ. And when the child comes into a personal faith in Christ, these things which were legalistically imposed on that child by the Christian parents will now become part of the law operating within the child. So again, we will see Romans 8 verse 3, the righteousness of the law being fulfilled in Christ. So please remember that the law simply does not mean that we can live immoral lives. We are going to live lives which are more moral than the morality of the Old Testament. But at the same time, we begin to understand that some of the ceremonial requirements, particularly separating the Jew from the Gentile, which was part of the Old Testament legal requirements, have been done away with Christ.